I'm Sean Berry and I work with BMC Server Automation. I'm here today to talk about standing up a new instance of BladeLogic for development or testing purposes. Today we're getting started with compliance and we're going to install the compliance content. So stay tuned. Okay, so one of the fastest and easiest server automation use cases to set up is policy-based compliance. The product ships with a number of out-of-the-box compliance policy templates including SOX, HIPAA, PCI, DISA, and CIS. These policies are easily modifiable by regular users with the appropriate access controls. These policies include out-of-the-box remediation instructions, which means that it makes it that much easier to bring your servers back into compliance if you find that they're out of compliance. So if you haven't restarted the file server agent since the application server install, go ahead and restart it now so that it picks up the path variables. And I'm going to take a little shortcut to that screen. Start run services.msc brings up the services tab real quickly. So there's our BMC server automation RCD agent. Go ahead and restart that. All right, so now we've got that restarted. So before we start this, this is another application that is going to run into the data execution prevention warning flag. So let's get that taken care of ahead of time. So let's go into the control panel. We're going to go into system. We're going to go into advanced system settings on the left. Advanced tab's already open. Go into performance settings and go over to data execution prevention. And let's go ahead and add the content Windows setup executable. Click on it right there. Since we already had to open it for the console installer, it's still here. But just hit OK. You see that now there's two entries for the install anywhere self-extractor. And I hit OK. OK. Go ahead and close that. All right, so now we can run this. We won't have to worry about the data execution prevention warning. Double click on the executable. Go ahead and click on next. We want to go ahead and agree to the licenses. Since we've already logged into the app server at least once, there's a profile built here. So we can just use default profile. Otherwise, if there wasn't one, we'd have to go add a new one. And then we can use our credentials here. And I'm going to use the BLadmin account. And let's go ahead and put our password in there. As a bit of an aside, these credentials will be used to create the content policies and remediation instructions. So make sure to use an account that has write access in the component templates and depot workspaces and who can create new properties. I usually use a BLadmin's role. Since this is for the demo environment, I'm using just the BLadmin user. You may need to use something different. And I'm going to go ahead and... So the app server hostname is pre-filled, and if you have more than one application server in your environment, you should click yes on the multi-app server prompt. Since this is a dev environment, we're just going to skip it. Alright, so here's our option to do full or custom setup. I'm going to take the custom setup path just so we can look at a couple of screens. Click custom, click next. So here's our list of available templates. There's the Sarbanes-Oxley templates, HIPAA, PCI, DISA templates, and of course the CIS templates. If there's a particular platform you won't be using, HPUX, AIX, whichever it happens to be, you can go ahead and uncheck it here. Since I'm going to be using these templates for a lot of other things, I'm going to go ahead and leave them all checked. It will take a little longer, but it's handy to have them here. You may want to do that for your environment as well if you may end up supporting a different platform at some point. So go ahead and click next. And the installer is going to go ahead and use a temp directory to extract things to. The default usually works for me, so I'm going to click next. And here's the list of everything it's going to go do and where it's going to stash things. Looks like about an 81 meg footprint. Go ahead and click install. And this is going to run for a decent amount of time. So I'm going to go ahead and let it sit here and run, and then we'll be back in a few minutes. All right, so that's the install. If there were problems, it'd be useful to go look at the install log, as you can see above. Otherwise, click done, and we're ready to move on to the next step. And if you want to come in here and hit, come into the GUI and hit refresh on component templates, I can see that, for example, the DISA and so forth are in here. And we'll get into what to do with these templates in the immediate next video. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video, which is how to run a compliance job. Thank you.